forecast for your area. Expect wintry conditions on Thursday and Friday, and on Saturday, expect fair skies.
A live look at the Olympic cauldron, and Vivian, what a difference from yesterday. We're showing this and there was beautiful blue skies. You could see the mountains in the background. You can't see any of that right now. Rain has moved in, or low clouds and fog have moved into the area with temperatures in the mid-40s, with some changes here.
Oh yeah, it doesn't look as pretty as it has in the last several days, but this is what still looks pretty. This is all that matters, right? The medal count, and the USA is still on top. Team USA has a total of 26 medals so far, thank you, including 7 of them which are gold. Germany has now racked in about 23 medals, and Norway takes the third spot with 17. Russia and the host country of Canada round out the top 5. Well, you know, the Winter Games had a few nice days, as mentioned, but all of that is changing now.
Yeah, let's hope the Germans don't, you know, continue to get those medals or catching up to us. All right, here's a look at the forecast for Vancouver. And I don't know if you're going to like this forecast or not, because it is going to be for rain over the next couple of days as the upper level ridge that's been over us, that big blocking ridge, begins to move away, and rain continues to come in all the way through Friday. The only nice day, Viv, is Saturday, and then 30% chance here for closing ceremonies.
Okay. Well, you know, one of the biggest spectator sports at the Olympics is snowboarding. The jumps, the twists, they are just amazing.
They really are. Mm-hmm. You know, they truly defy the laws of gravity. NBC's Lester Holt takes a look at the science behind the board.
Ever since snowboarding made its Olympics debut 12 years ago, it's taken off worldwide.
So tell me in Italian, you would say, I'm going snowboarding.
Vado a fare snowboard.
The lingo that American snowboarders use might still sound like a foreign language to some.
I dropped into a crippler 2x3, and after that I was like, woo woo!
But the science that these boarders use to do tricks on the half pipe couldn't be simpler. The laws of gravity, building speed, and especially balance. At the Exploratorium Museum in San Francisco, senior staff scientist Paul Doherty knows a thing or two about the physics of snowboarding. He even created a model to illustrate how snowboarders keep their balance in the half pipe. Stay upright without taking a spill.
If I'm building up my motion in the half pipe back and forth, I can go all the way up to the rim and the water stays level in the glass. A snowboarder has to remember that when they're in the half pipe. They have to feel not only gravity straight down, but the forces of the snow on them, which change angle as they move.
As gravity pulls snowboarders down the half pipe, they gain speed. But at the very same time, they're being pushed against the sides of the half pipe by contact forces from the surface of the snow.
That snowboarder feels like they're being crushed against the surface.
By standing up against those extra forces in the curve, snowboarders add to their kinetic energy, the energy of motion. And that gives them the speed they need to get air. That potential energy will come in handy in Vancouver, where the new in-ground superpipe created for the 2010 Olympics will be the biggest one ever, rising 22 feet high. At that height, we'll see some awesome tricks, and the boarders will have more time to hang out in the air.
Okay, some exciting stuff, and you know it's going to be just as exciting tonight. Here's a look at the events that will start at 8.